you just watched is a project that I've been working on for a little while. It's an openTX Lua script that sort of exploits how custom mixes work to overwrite the sticks with pre-programmed movements as soon as you hit a button. It uses the built-in timer on the Taranis to time everything and make sure everything works properly. And the way it's written makes it really easy to program your own tricks and make it do whatever you want, really. Right now it can hold three different tricks at once, but it would be super easy, pretty much trivial to expand it to do more. The tricks I pre-programmed into it really are just there to demonstrate how the thing works. So I wrote this to work on the Taranis because that's what I have, but it's super simple to make it work on the QX7. There's just a few little changes that need to be made. So I'm going to go through how it all works and how you can set it up, how you can tune it, how you can write your own tricks. And there's a few steps, but it's not nearly as complicated as you might think. The biggest part is getting the timing right and tuning it for your setup. So there's something I want to make clear, and that is that this is not a replacement for actually learning how to do these tricks on your own. Learning how to do FPV tricks is fun and it's rewarding and, you know, extremely satisfying when you finally nail them. And getting your radio to do the tricks for you is not nearly as rewarding. You know, they're fairly simple tricks, and it'll likely take you less time to learn how to do the tricks than to set up your radio to do them. I know for me, it took me way less time to learn how to do these tricks than to write the software and get it working and tune it and get everything working on my Taranis. But, I mean, it was super fun. And I did this for a number of reasons. The first was that I wanted to learn more about Lua scripting in an openTX environment. I wanted to see how far I could push it, and I wanted to see what it would actually do, and this was a great way to do that. Second of all, I it was just fun to do, and I wanted to share what I did with you guys and make what I did available for anybody else who wants to check it out and learn from it. And probably the biggest reason is I wanted to push the technology as far as I thought I could. And, you know, other than some toy drones that do automatic flips or rolls, I don't think anybody has done this, at least not to this extent. And so by unleashing this on the world, I was hoping that maybe it would inspire people to do other things with this concept. You know, the idea of exactly repeatable stick movements that can be done automatically has probably more applications than just doing tricks. So for example, in hardware testing, motor testing, prop testing, there's probably some applications there, or in helping test PIDs and helping set PIDs and things like that. And I'm sure there's all sorts of things that I haven't thought of. So hopefully, you know, this will be kind of a springboard that people will take to develop other ideas based on this concept. And I've even got a project that I thought of in the middle of working on this that I've already started working on. So hopefully that'll see daylight soon too. And, you know, the last reason is I can't lie. It's damn fun to see your quad do a trick when you hit a button. It's just really neat. It's really neat feeling, and it's super fun to do, and it's super addictive. So I just kind of love doing it. So there are some gotchas. It isn't perfect. And probably the biggest one is that you can't use it right out of the box. The default tricks were written for my quad, for my setup, my rates, my camera angle, and yours are likely different. So it needs to be tuned to your setup, because if it's not tuned to your setup, it won't work very well, or it won't work at all. It isn't hard to tune, but it won't work right away without tuning. So you're going to have a little bit of work to make it work properly. The second is that orientation is important. So it doesn't know what angle your quad is on. It doesn't know where level is. And so if you've got a trick that does a 180 and you start like this, it'll end up like this. If you start like this, it'll end up like this. And so any of these tricks that you run, when you hit the switch, you always have to be at exactly the same orientation. You can't start a trick like that. You can't start a trick like that and expect it to perform as the same as if you started the trick like that. I considered building in an auto level stage that happens right at the beginning of every trick. So, you know, you would always start from this position. But what I found is that it really isn't all that hard to make sure you start a trick from the same position. It makes it so you can't, you know, do a trick in the middle of a turn or something like that, but that's really not a big deal. So that is a constraint. The other thing is that you have to be very, very careful with this, which brings me to warnings. So what you need to keep in mind is this script completely takes over your sticks, which means when a trick is being executed, you have zero control over the quad. So what that means is if you've played around with the script or the tricks, and instead of telling it to roll for 0.5 seconds, you tell it to go full throttle for 50 seconds or something like that, you know, you could lose your quad, you could break your quad, you could hurt yourself, you could hurt somebody else. So tread carefully when you're making changes to the script. I highly suggest testing it in a simulator first. And yes, it does work on a simulator. Personally, when I was playing around with the script and writing this and getting it working and getting all the tricks going, I had at least a couple of complete flyaways. I'm just really happy that I was testing it in a simulator and not in real life. That's actually another gotcha, is the simulator doesn't really behave exactly like a real quad. And you know, that's no big surprise, but what did surprise me is that in the simulator, I use Velocidrone, and I set my rates exactly the same as I do on my regular quad. And the trick would, let's say, do a 180 roll. And in the simulator, it would do a 180 roll, but in real life, it would go maybe 270 degrees. So a really big difference. So the way that the simulator behaves is pretty different from real life. And that's actually maybe another application of this, is because we have stick movements that can be replicated exactly, it'd be a great way to tune a simulator to behave exactly the same way as a real quad. All right, I'm going to explain how all of these switches work. So just keep in mind that the switches are completely assignable. So just because I use a switch for a certain function doesn't mean you're stuck using the same switch. It's really easy to do in the script, and I'll tell you a little bit later how that's done. So the first switch is the trick select switch, and it's exactly what it sounds like. In position one, it selects trick one. Position two selects trick two. Position three selects trick three. And so that will be the trick that it performs when you actually tell it to perform the trick. Which leads us to this switch, which is the go switch, which is the switch that you flick to actually perform the trick. And it needs to be on a momentary switch. If you hold it down, it'll just keep performing that trick over and over again until you let it go. So that's how you actually perform the trick. The next switch is this kind of safety switch. In the center position, it will perform the trick as normal. If it's not in the center position, if it's anywhere else, it won't actually perform a trick. It doubles as an abort button. So if you're in the middle of a trick and you need to abort for some reason, just throw that to a position other than the center and it'll stop the trick right away and give you control back to your sticks. And then the last switch is this segment switch. In the center position, again, it doesn't do anything. When you start a trick, it'll just do a trick as normal. If you put it in the first position, it will only do the first segment of a trick. So if your trick is to flip over 180 degrees and then flip back to the start, it'll only do that first flip. And the reason that's useful is so you can do just that one segment and tune it so it flips, you know, exactly how far you want it to flip. In this position here, it'll only do the second segment of the trick. So it's great for tuning. which brings us to the knobs. So we've got four switches and four knobs. On the QX7, there's only two knobs. So what this knob does is it adjusts the timing for the first segment of the trick. You turn it left, it'll do that segment for a little bit less time. You turn it right, it'll do it for more time. And in the center position, it doesn't affect it at all. And again, this is used for tuning. So if you're testing your trick and the first flip, let's say, doesn't quite get over far enough, increase the time a little bit and it'll do the flip for a little bit longer. So this one affects the first segment. This one affects the second segment. This slider here affects the third segment. And this slider affects the fourth segment. And again, like I said, in the QX7, you'll only have the first and second. So that's how it works. So now I'm going to tell you how to install it on your computer. The first thing that you need to do is turn off your Tyrannus, hold these two trims together and turn it on. And you can see it puts it into bootloader mode. So when you put it into bootloader mode, then you can plug in the USB here into your computer. And let's move over to the computer. All right, I'm going to show you how to install the script on your Tyrannus. It's super easy. And I'm going under the assumption that you have the most current version of openTX on your Tyrannus, and it's built with Lua scripting enabled. If you don't have the most current version, or you've built it without Lua scripting, then just Google how to do that. It's super easy to do. You just have to download the most current version, click on the Lua script, and write it to your radio. But assuming you've done that, what you need to do is follow the link in the video to this GitHub page, and you are going to want to click clone or download, download zip, and you get this folder, and this is the file right here that you need, tricks.lua. So copy that onto your desktop or wherever you want to copy it. I've already got it here, so I don't need it. Once you've done that, make sure your Tyrannus is plugged in and it's in bootloader mode. And you'll get two drives. There'll be a Tyrannus drive and another USB drive. And the Tyrannus drive is not the one that you want. You want the additional USB drive. So if you go into that, open scripts, then mixes, and then take that tricks.lua and copy it into your mixes folder. And that is it. All right, now I'm going to explain how to set up the Tyrannus. So first, make sure you have the right model selected, then hit menu. We're gonna hit page 11 times. And it should come up with this custom scripts page. And if you do not have this, it's because your OpenTX was not built with the Lua script option enabled. So if you don't have this page, you're going to have to go back and reflash your radio with the Lua script option checked off. So when we're here, we go to Lua 1. We hit enter. And then enter again on the script field. And we choose tricks, the Lua script that we put on the SD card. We go down here, give it a name. Let's name it trick. All right. So these are the inputs that the script is looking for. So we need to assign inputs to each of those. So what we do is we assign the sticks to the inputs to the script. So throttle here, hold down enter until it comes up with this page, go to sticks, and we go to throttle. Now yaw will be rudder, roll will be aileron, pitch will be elevator. There we go. Those are all the inputs, and these are all the outputs from the script. So you can see throttle, yaw, roll, pitch. So nothing is, it's not doing anything right now because you're not actually, you haven't started a trick. So you can see how it just sort of reflects the stick values back to the radio. And if you run a trick, watch what happens. You can see it modifying those values there. So now what we need to do is we need to set up the custom mix. So we'll exit out of here, hit menu again, and go to the mixer page. There's the mixer page. And so this shows all the outputs from the mixer. And so what we have to do is we have to set it up so instead of throttle coming from the stick, throttle comes actually from the Lua script. So the first one here is aileron. So hold down enter on that. Go to insert after. Now aileron is roll. So let's call this roll. Now the source for roll, we're going to set to the Lua script. Okay, so you look for the Lua script. So you look for, it starts with a 1, okay? And there, 1 roll. So Lua script output called roll. And we go down to multiplexing and edit that and change it to replace. So that one's done. You can see it appears right underneath that channel. So the next channel for me is elevator, and that's pitch. So hold down enter, insert after. Daddy. Let's call it something here. Call it pitch. And the source will be elevator. So Lua scripts. Sorry, the source will be pitch. There we go. Then we go down to multiplexing. Change that to replace. So we do that with all the rest of them. So throttle. Insert after. Throttle. And the source for throttle will be the Lua script output called throttle. Here we go. Whoops. Go down to multiplex. Change that to replace. Exit out. We got one more to do. And that's rudder, which is yaw. Hold down enter. Insert after. Let's call it yaw. And the source for yaw will be the Lua script yaw. There we go. And go down to multiplexing. Change that to replace. There we go. We've got our mix completely set up. And there's one last thing that we need to do, and that is calibrate the knobs. So we hold down menu until it comes up with this screen. And then we go to calibration, hit enter, get everything centered. Make sure all the knobs are centered. Hit enter and move everything. Move all of these from all the way to both ends, and move these all the way to both ends, back to center, and hit enter. And there we are. All right. Before we can actually tune the script, first we need to set up the switch assignments. So the way in which we do that is make sure your Tyrannus is in bootloader mode, plug it into your computer, and then we just go find the script in the same place that we put it. So in my case, it's the iDrive, scripts, mixes. So that's the file that you want to edit. And you can use Notepad or any other text editor to edit. I like to use ZB Studio, which is really good for editing code. So here's what the script looks like. If you have problems or questions or issues, feel free to contact me at any of these three places. And I highly recommend reading through all of these notes. There's some warnings in here and some helpful information on how to set your rates and all that kind of stuff. The first thing that we need to do is we need to scroll down here and look at the switch assignments. So if you notice on your Tyrannus, all the switches are labeled. So this statement right here sets the segment switch, which is the switch that we use to pick just a single segment of the trick or the full trick to execute. I have it set to switch A. If I want it on switch B, I can just change it. So you set all your switch assignments here. The trick select switch, the go switch, which has to be a momentary switch, which is the switch that you use to actually execute a trick. And then the disable trick, which is that panic button or abort switch that you can use. In the center section, it'll allow the trick to happen. If it's anywhere else, the trick won't happen. Or if you're in the middle of a trick and you switch this to one of the non-center position, it'll cancel or abort the trick. If you don't have enough switches left on your radio, you could get rid of this one. I highly recommend leaving it because it's, you know, really handy to be able to cancel a trick. Or if you're going to hand your radio to somebody else to fly your quad with and you want to make it harder for them to, hit the automatic trick by accident or something like that. The way you do that is you take out this entire line and then you scroll down here to this line right here and take this part of that line out. And then that switch won't be used at all. And if you have a QX7 instead of a Tyrannus, there's a few notes here that explain what to do to the script to make it work for the QX7. And really, it's all about those two sliders that the QX7 doesn't have. So I'll explain how these tricks work. And there's an explanation of it in the description here. But each trick is a set of arrays. So each move on the trick, so each segment of the trick is an array. So this is trick number one, move number one. And what this means is for 260 milliseconds, the Tyrannus works in 10 millisecond increments, so at 26 means 260 milliseconds, drop the throttle down to nothing. So the sticks range from -1024 to +1024. Don't do anything with the yaw. Don't do anything with the roll. And set the pitch to almost a full stick deflection back. So I don't use quite full stick deflection because it ends up bouncing a little too much when it zeroes back again. So I use a little bit less. It softens it up and makes it just a tiny little bit smoother. So the syntax for this is right here. It explains it. Oops. Time, throttle, yaw, roll, pitch. So each segment, this array describes what it's supposed to do. And at the end, you always end it with zeros because that's what tells it that the trick is done. So for example, on this one, the way I calculated this is what I wanted to do is have the quad go from pitching just a little bit forward, because I'm assuming that I'm moving forward when I start this trick, back to the quad being flat.
So the camera, because I have camera tilt, will be pointing a little bit down, but the quad itself will be flat. And the reason I did that is because it makes the next move, the yaw, just a little bit easier, because I can do pure yaw without having to mix in any roll. So the way I calculated this is my rates are set to 800 degrees per second for pitch. So if I go to Google and I say I want to turn a little bit more than 180 degrees because I'm pitching forward and I need to go back all the way to flat. So let's say about 200 degrees out of 800, I get 0.25 seconds. So that's 250 milliseconds, which would turn out to be 25. Now I ended up having to tune it a little bit, so it ended up at 26 for me. The next move is a yaw. And again, my yaw is set a little bit slower, 500 degrees per second. So it a full turn all the way around ended up being 710 milliseconds. Drops the throttle to zero. And most of the time you're gonna have the throttle set to zero on these. And then a negative, almost full stick of yaw for that 710 milliseconds. And then it flips back. And the flip back happens a little bit faster than the first flip because we end up flat. We don't end up pitching forward. So here we're starting from pitching forward all the way around about 200 degrees. Here ends up being maybe about 160 degrees. The next trick is the backwards knife edge. And what it does first is it flips back, and it doesn't go to the quad being flat, it goes to the camera being flat because I wanted it to look a little bit better. In this case, with the upside down yaw spin, the camera is pointing a little bit down, which I kind of like the look of it. And like I said, it made the trick easier to program. But here I wanted the camera to be flat, which means the quad is not flat. So this gets the quad to pointing backwards. And then what I had to do is, because the quad isn't flat, I had to mix in a little bit of roll with my yaw, because I want to yaw up 90 degrees because I'm doing a knife edge. And so I needed to mix in a little bit of roll with my yaw. And the way I calculated that is I have a 30 degree camera tilt. So if my camera tilt was 45 degrees, I would mix in exactly the same amount of yaw or roll as I would yaw. But I'm at 30 degrees, so 30 divided by 45 is 67%. So I need 67% of yaw. Now, I can't just go minus 670 here because I use Expo. It's not a linear relationship. So what I do is I go to this link right here. And I type in my rates. I use 0.75 Super Expo. And it calculates my curve. So what did I need? 667. Oops. Sorry, that didn't take. My RC rate is 1. My Super rate is 0.75. And my RC Expo is 0. There we go. Okay, so there's my curve. So we need 667. So that's about the closest point right there, 668. So what it's saying is at 95% stick deflection, that will give me 668 degrees per second. So what I need is 95% of 1024, not 1000 because full stick is a 1024. Now that comes out to what, 960. I ended up having to tune it a little bit. I don't know why, just the way my quad was set up. So at first I put in, 960 or 970 or something like that. But I ended up tuning it back. And then of course it ends the trick. So that's how these tricks work. That's how the rates work. You're going to have to go in here and change all of these. Unless your rates and your quad work exactly like mine and your camera tilt is exactly like mine, you're gonna have to go in and change these. Just be very, very careful. Once you change them, test it out in the simulator. Don't test it out live.
Okay, so I'm gonna show you how to actually tune the timing of your tricks. Now, when I first started doing this, I didn't have any way to tune the timing. What I would do is I would do the trick and it wouldn't work out right. So I'd plug it into my tablet. I'd go into the script. I'd adjust all the values, try the trick again, and so on and so forth. And it was really hard because I had no way to break up the trick into different segments. So if I was doing an inverted yaw spin, it would flip, spin, flip again, all really quickly, one after another. So I couldn't tell if the first flip was landing in the right spot or not. So anyway, I had to write a system to be able to tune this so it wouldn't take me nearly as long. And I just left it in here so you guys can use it too. So what we do is we tune the segments independently, and each of these knobs and sliders here adjust the timing of each of the segments. So knob one will adjust the timing of segment one, and this has a range of 100 milliseconds. So remember, the Tyrannus works in 10 millisecond chunks, so this adjusts the timing for segment one from minus 10 all the way to plus 10. So if we hit menu here and we go over to the Lua script and hit enter, these are all the outputs from the script. So it outputs the throttle, the yaw, the roll, and the pitch. And you can see when you do a trick, it actually sends those to the radio. Down here are the knob values. Now, unfortunately, a Lua script can only have 6 outputs, and 4 are already being used by the sticks. So we've only got 2 left, and yet we've got 4 modifiers for the timing for our segments. So what I did here is, if I move one, so you can see, I'll move that up to 10. So it displays the first 2 knobs, so 10 and 10, and then it displays the sliders. Knobs, then sliders. And the way you know which is it's displaying is the knobs display for a little bit longer than the sliders. So knobs, sliders. So these adjust the timing of each respective segment of the trick. So if you've got 4 segments, that's segment 1, 2, 3, 4. So what I do is, let's say we're going to work on the inverted yaw spin. So I set that to the yaw spin, and then I switch this switch to only be the first segment. So if I run the trick here, you'll see it flips and then that's it. It doesn't do anymore. If I put it to the center position, which is the full trick, you see it flips, spins, and then flips again. So we'll go just the first segment. This knob here will adjust the timing in 10 second increments from minus 100 milliseconds up to 100 milliseconds. So it'll add or subtract milliseconds to that move. And so if we look at the flip here, it's pretty quick. If we take time off of it, it's even faster. And if we add 100 milliseconds, it's longer. So what we do is we go and we fly and do the trick, the first segment of the trick, and get to right where the quad is flat at the end of the flip. And we might have to adjust it up. And once we get it, or down, and once we get it exactly right, you make note of that, 2.4. So what we have to do is go back into the script and on that segment of the trick, add 2 or 3 values, which is 20 or 30 milliseconds. So if we've got negative 4, that means I have to take 4 off the timing for that trick. And then what I do is I move on to the second segment, and I use that one to adjust the second. Now, there's no way to, the way it's set up right now, to do just the third and fourth segments. So, unfortunately, you're going to have to do the full trick when you're adjusting the third and fourth segments. So that's how you do it. You estimate the values at first in your script using the calculated method that I showed you, and then you go in and you tune them perfectly. And it works really well. And the side benefit of the way this single segment works is, on the inverted yaw spin, I can put that to the first segment, and now I've got a 180 on a switch, because that segment is a 180. The second segment is a yaw, so I can be in any kind of situation. If I want a yaw, I can be upside down or right side up, and it'll yaw all the way around. So that's just part of the trick. So it's more than just three tricks in one. So that's how you tune the tricks. So the next step is to load up the simulator, play around with the tricks, try tuning them, get the knob position so the moves are all working properly, then go back into the script and adjust the script. So hard code those modified values that you've figured out in the tuning. And, you know, it won't translate into real life exactly, but at least you'll get a feel for how the tricks work, and you'll get a feel for tuning. So once you actually get your quad out there, you'll know how to tune it fairly quickly. I just put those tricks in there to demonstrate how the script works. The point is to experiment and try some stuff on your own, come up with your own tricks. And of course, the big goal is that it might inspire people to keep pushing this technology forward and to do even more interesting things. I'm really interested to see what people can do with this idea and what might become of it. So enjoy. And thin and young and lovely, the girl from Ipanema goes far.